Hi everyone, my name's Andrew Laughlin and I'm an assistant professor in environmental studies here at UNC Asheville. And I'm also the Ornithology Science Mentor for the Eco Explore program with North Carolina Arboretum. I wanted to talk to you a little bit about how I became interested in birds. I was actually a late bloomer when it came to my interest in birds. I knew as a child my favorite bird was the northern cardinal. It was a bright red bird with a black mask. And I think I probably had an affinity for animals with black masks because raccoons were my favorite mammal at the time too. But it actually wasn't until after I graduated from college when I really became interested in birds and knew that that's what I wanted to do for the rest of my life. I remember the day really well. I took a walk at a local wildlife refuge near my house in Portland, Oregon, and I saw a sign advertising this refuge as the home of the largest great blue heron rookery within city limits in the United States. So I thought, I wonder how long ago that was, because the city had gotten really large and I was sure that the great blue herons probably moved out a long time ago. And so I asked these people in the refuge. They had binoculars, they were looking around, and I said, when's the last time anyone saw a great blue heron here in the park? They actually gave me their binoculars and said, there's about 30 of them right now if you look over this wetland. And I took the binoculars and I couldn't believe that they were still there, living in the middle of the city. From there, it was all over. I was hooked. I bought a pair of binoculars. I bought a Peterson's Field Guide to Western Birds. And I went down to visit this place as often as I could. And I still remember the first bird I was ever able to identify by myself. It was a bird about the size of a blue jay. It had a little bit longer bill, longer pointed bill. It had these beautiful speckles all over its belly, and it had a red streak along its cheek. I paged through every page of that book that I could find. I finally found it. It was the northern flicker. It was a type of woodpecker. I'm still fascinated with birds in the city. One research project I'm working on right now involves chimney swifts and their communal roosts inside chimneys across the city of Asheville. Chimney swifts are birds that breed inside chimneys, but every autumn they also use these chimneys as communal roosts, these locations where hundreds and sometimes even thousands of birds will spend the night together. I'm interested in finding out where these chimney swift roosts are located and which chimneys are the most important. And this is where you come in. Scientists depend on citizen scientists like yourself to make observations and report those observations so that we can understand what happens at over large areas like cities. I depend on citizen scientists to gather information about chimney swift roosts across Asheville. You all take photographs of dragonflies, beetles, plants, frogs, and you submit that data, and scientists can use that data to understand where plants and animals live and when and where they occur. So thank you for being part of this program. It helps scientists gather data that's very hard to gather on our own.